Now back to Rick Suds and Neil.
Now, did you install it, just put it in there, or did you configure it also?
What the hell does that mean? Did I configure it also?
You have to configure it also. Did you configure it also? There's a, like a gateway number, a DNS number, a secondary. It's a pain in the butt, a secondary DNS number, and they gave you the instructions for all of that for your server and all
they
of that?
No, no instructions. The numbers, I have all those numbers, but I was at no point did it ever ask to put those in.
Yeah, it won't
I went
ask
through
you.
The whole. Well, where are you going to stick it?
You got to.
Oh, brother!
In the modem. Oh, it is. It's a pain in the butt. You got to go. What he did was get Netscape yesterday.
I spent 6.5 hours, and I don't know why. It must have been a really extra boring day, but I spent 6.5 hours.
Because you get locked into this stuff,
getting
like
into
like
the
you
web
get it to work.
And then I finally realized that on which one was it? It was on AOL. No, it was on CompuServe.
Yeah.
That instead of doing all that diddling around and downloading the web browser, and then it doesn't. All you got to do is just go up there and stick your damn address in there on the thing, and it was on Prodigy. That's what it was.
Yeah.
And that's it.
In Prodigy.
Right.
Yeah, but
Prodigy is really easy access. I mean,
right,
Prodigy sucks, but it's easy to get in.
And it's limited service. And it's real slow.
Yeah, it is slow.
So if you invest $40 in Netscape, in the box,
right,
it'll tell you exactly how to do it, where to put this stuff in, and once you're up and running, you won't have to touch it. You can just click on it.
Well, I'll just call this guy on Monday. He's left me his number.
Exactly.
I mean, the price was right. It was
exactly.
Very nice.
have him do it for you. But there's a lot of configuring that you have to do, and you got to set up DNS. And I don't even know what they all are, but if you have one thing out of place, it doesn't fly. It doesn't connect.
Yeah.
It just says cannot establish
right.
protocol,
right.
And
exactly.
You're out of here. So that's what happened. You got to
configure. And I thought, gee, this was a snap. I mean, I did everything, you know, no problem.
Yeah. Computers, they are.
Piece of crap. Like to take that thing and stick it in the bottom of the pool.
So we have lines open in Dade, 751.
No, seriously. So, and then I was talking to somebody about me, because I have a 486, okay?
Yeah.
And I was thinking about maybe going out and getting a new one.
Right.
And then they said, well, you don't know, because, of course, the new one will have Windows 95, and it's going to take you a while to get comfortable with that, and you got to get the new keyboard, and you're going to be like
you don't have to get any new keyboard. It won't take you a while at all. It's much friendlier. It's much better to use than Windows. Everybody said, see, Adam, you haven't even tried it. I played around with Windows 95. Do you have it on your computer? Whose did you use?
And my mom has 95 on it.
Well, you don't just stop by. You get comfortable with it. It's a lot better than regular Windows, believe me. A lot
better. In what respect?
It's easier
it's
to
like
use. It's more.
It's almost what? Like an Apple.
It's like new Coke. It's just the same product repackaged, and it
wrong.
Sucks a lot
wrong.
Worse.
Absolutely wrong. It's much more logical. It's easier to get around. It's easier to figure stuff out, and it's much better. What you ought to do is get a Pentium 166 with all that crap installed.
Yeah.
You would love it. It's much faster. It'll make it seem like you were just sitting there just waiting forever to do things that this thing just does instantly.
There's nothing like downloading one of these web browsers and, you know, 36
forever.
Minutes.
Yeah.
And you go back in the other room and you watch TV and then you
right.
come back and you keep looking. At one point, it got interrupted. That was my favorite.
Right.
Oh, no. But at least I was able to get back in the file and just resume as opposed to start from scratch. It was like 60% done.
Right.
And then you go back and finally it gets all done. And then you go to use it, and sorry, you have to have an integrated web browser to get into that.
Right.
And I just downloaded one. Well, too bad,
yeah,
but don't
confuse
us
with that.
You have
to have it to use it to set it up. Well, I can't set it up. That's right, because you don't have it.
Yeah.
Right. But
no, but I just downloaded it from their free software. I just downloaded the Mother Scratcher, okay? I just took 36 minutes of my life of running back in and out and looking to make sure everything was, you know,
right.
copacetic and listening to all that, you know, for half an hour.
Right.
And then,
That's
sorry.
The life of computers. Last night, I went to
And then when I got in there on Prodigy and I realized how easy it was to do whatever the hell I wanted.
But it's
limited.
Miserable. It's limited.
It's limited, but at least, you know.
You can't do whatever you want. You can't get to, like, the good stuff. You know, Prodigy censors
That's not
their
true
stuff.
At all. No, they don't.
That's what I hear.
They sure didn't censor what I found in there. There was naked guys wrapped in a lip lock.
Really?
Yeah.
A lip lock
I don't want to say what was in their lip. And that wasn't even what I was looking for.
Well, anyway, I...
That's what Adam is looking for.
See, I've been getting these free Netscape copies. I finally went out and bought one.
Yeah.
And things have been fine ever since then. No problems. I dial up and everything's fine. It does it all for you. And I figure, sure, they're going to make it when you pay for it, that everything kind of settles in. Other than that, if you're going to get free copies and somebody gives you discs, you got to go
know what
you're doing.
And I got a bad sound card in my damn computer, too. And like
you
some,
need a new
no,
computer.
No, remember I told you about that problem?
Right.
And some days it's fine, and then within the same day sometimes it
right.
works. And some, and you know, what the hell is a computer without the audio? So that when you turn it off, you don't hear bing. You know, I mean, it's no fun if you don't hear that
right.
little bing.
In the zips.
In the zips.
Now, when you pay your checks, does it go and rip one off? And the check, too?
Yeah.
Mine does.
No, it does not.
Mine goes like
no,
you're ripping off the
that.
Checkbook.
No, it doesn't.
And Quicken.
Well, why the hell do I want to do that?
Well, you want a sound card. You want audio.
I thought
it does
you don't
that.
Write checks.
No, when I pay him, when you pay him electronically, you write a little check.
I'm not
going to
pay him electronically. I don't want to do that.
You already write checks, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I just asked you the question. Does it go, that's all?
No.
Okay, then.
But I do have a laser printer, and they just, that's great. I finally got me a laser printer.
Get a...
Isn't that like moving almost into the 18th century?
Kind of.
Yeah.
Get a Pentium.
I have, mine is a Pentium.
Yours is, if it's a 486, it's
right.
not a Pentium.
Yes, it is. You're wrong.
It can't be.
Okay, then it lies on the front
of
it.
Oh, that's
okay.
right. You have a 486 model.
Right.
It's
no,
not
a 406 model, but it's a 486.
Okay, let me lay this out to you. When they started, they made the 286, they made the 8086 chip. Then they made the 286 chip, then the 386, then the 486.
Yeah.
But they did not want to name it a 586. They wanted to do new marketing, so they called a 586 a Pentium.
Yeah.
Now the new 686
this
is
one
out.
Is a Pentium, trust me. There's
well,
no question.
Okay, then it's
then
not
maybe,
a 486.
Then maybe the book that I got is from my first computer, which
right.
was a 486.
Well, there you go.
So, in other words, I'm ahead of the game. So
right.
what do I want a new computer for?
You just got one, apparently, just now. Because now you got a Pentium.
I already told you I had a Pentium. I already told you that when I told you what the model number was 406. You freaked out. There's no such thing.
No, I didn't. You told me you had... Did he just tell me
how,
he had a 486
How many
just
times
now?
Did I tell him the model number was 406 CD? There's
right.
no such thing.
We've
been through
that.
This three times
right.
already.
You were right.
Like I'm
I
making
was wrong.
It up. Like it's some kind of a communist plot.
You were right. I was wrong. What I'm saying now is today you said you had a 486.
Well, I thought it was.
Okay. And now
what
you
do
have
I
a
know about this? I'm not, you know, I have better things to do with 6.5 hours than sit there and waste my life.
Yeah.
God, was that a waste of time?
Oh, if I could tell you the hours I've wasted on a computer, sure.
Frustrating.
It takes forever. And you got to go to the exact little thing that make it what?
That reminds me. What kind of modem do you have, Neil? 35 minutes to download something. I'm just curious.
Programs are like awfully big, even with a 28.8 modem. I run into 35, 40-minute downloads.
1440.
Oh, get rid of that.
Oh.
Slow.
Yeah.
Well, if he has his
the new one would be 28.8.
I know that.
Now, what
well,
we're talking about...
33.4.
Oh.
Well, with compression. But, see, yours does make that sound.
Yeah.
Now...
No, I'm hoping it does.
What you need to do is, instead of getting this new computer, since now you already have one, and you've saved all that money, get an ISDN modem.
Right.
For 128K.
Right.
That 6.5 hours setting that up will seem like
That's
nothing.
That's 500
We
bucks.
Won't see you for weeks. 350 to 500.
350?
Yeah.
Like I said, 500.
With 128K per minute? That's
mm-hmm.
pretty quick.
Yeah. Oh, this thing is slow.
So now let's get back to this guy in Parkland. Hello.
Hey, Rick.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I forgot to get a number off you.
Now, is it still raining?
Yeah, still
okay,
pouring
good.
Out raining.
All right, we
now,
still...
Now, since I gave you some good information, I want a special number.
No, you can't have a special number.
Come
ever.
On. I got one you
As a matter of fact, since you live in Parkland, we're going to devalue your number to go
Parkland.
Along with your property prices.
Hey, I work in Parkland.
Oh, okay. What do you do there?
I'm a heavy equipment operator.
Oh.
Oh.
Now, do you know Roger Stepp?
Nope.
Okay, Roger's been doing my lawn. Where is he lately?
I don't find because your grass ain't grown because they had no water.
Well, exactly. He's afraid to come back because he doesn't want to see everything dead.
That's it.
Well, now it's live, Roger. Come on home. Go ahead, sir.
Oh, yeah, I want the number 0.
To match.
I can understand that.
Your...
My IQ, if you want to say.
I knew you were going there. Okay.
Okay.
All
658,
right.
Roger.
No, this isn't Roger.
I thought it was number one.
Match his penis size.
Well, now, what is... His name was Roger.
What
What's
is your
name?
Jeff.
Jeff.
Oh, my
God. Yeah, I'm a Virgo.
No, it is, then.
Well, congratulations, Jeff.
I appreciate it.
All right, we'll see you later. Let's try mobile. Hello.
Hey, Rick.
Hello, sir.
How you doing?
Okay.
I just want to say that I was listening to Neil talk about his computer. If it is a 486 and it's not a Pentium.
No, I think we settled
it. It is a Pentium.
So it's not a 486.
So then it's not a 486, right?
Right.
Okay, what you can do if you find out what it is... what kind is it?
Packard Bell, right?
Right.
See, most of, I guess you bought it out of a store, retail outlet, right?
Right.
See, most of the time, they make them so where you can't upgrade them. You have a problem. Instead of just upgrading the chip or something like that, you have to upgrade a lot more than that. And when it comes out, you end up spending just as much money as buying a new computer. That's a bad thing about buying them from stores.
Right, well, he doesn't want to upgrade his. He said,
no,
well,
I'll get a new one
computer.
Anyway. I just want to take this one and smash it with a ball-peen hammer. I'll get a new one.
Now they have the Pentium Pro, the 686, 200 megahertz. It does stuff before you even think about it.
Well, yeah, I don't know
for
about
my,
that.
$4,000?
No, three.
Yeah.
Yeah, what's wrong with that?
Yeah, that's not too bad.
I'll tell you what, though. If,
we'll get another Sony XBR for that money.
I've got about five in mine.
A lot of new reports are saying that the 200 megahertz compared to like a 100.
Yeah.
It's a lot more expensive, and the performance isn't that much
that's
better.
That's what
it's
I said.
It's not that much good because the motherboard can't keep up.
The motherboard has a 66 megahertz bus, but the thing to get is either a 133 or a 166.
Right.
That's the optimum value right now.
Right. I would go with the 133 because it's a lot cheaper than 66.
Yeah.
But you know what you do? Neil, if you're going to buy a new one, if I were you, I would buy through mail order.
Gateway.
Gateway's a good product.
Don't say Dell.
Well, no, I wouldn't say Dell. I don't know. If you look at all the magazines, Dell's usually
Dell is right
one.
On top. I know, but I got their one of their computers, and one of the things I didn't want the CD-ROM, so they said we'll send the whole computer back. And I said, man, these things are components. I'll send back a CD-ROM. You send me a CD-ROM. Oh no, can't do it that way. Now Gateway will swap out part for part.
Well, you know what? I heard about Dell is that they also, when they build their computers, they were caught using used parts putting in a new computer.
So was Gateway, but they don't do that anymore.
Okay, now I'll tell you what. I just bought a new one. I was going to buy a Gateway, and the last minute I changed my mind, there's a computer out there called a Micron.
That's right. Micron's a great company.
And I bought a Micron. I didn't really know anything about it.
And it's an excellent value, too, and I bet you're really happy with it.
I am happy with it. Yeah. I don't really know that much about computers, but, you know, I've just been learning lately, and I'll tell you what, to buy through the mail order is a lot better. You actually save a lot of money. The warranties are just as good, and everything is totally upgradable.
Well, you got to look at it this way. Your help is going to be by phone anyway, so what does it matter if you're calling somebody, you know, 50 miles away or somebody 500 miles away? You're still on the phone getting help.
The only thing different is that if you buy one from the store and you get some piece of crap that you get home and it's not working, then you can at least bring it back. Mail order, if you get one like that, which you don't really
mail
get as many.
Yeah, but wait a second, pal. Mail order, they'll do on-site service for the first year. So they'll
That's
come
right
out to your house. So you don't
right.
need to worry about taking it back. They'll take it back for you if you need to.
That's right.
Mail order and Micron is an excellent company. And I hear Dell is, even though I didn't like their deal. And Gateway is. Those are three excellent computers.
Hey, let's not forget, Sony hits the market in about 3 months.
Well, I'll tell you what, Neil.
Yeah.
My computer is a Pentium 100, and now they don't even make it. They make 120, and I only bought it a month and a half ago. But it's a Pentium 120. It's got all. It's 16 megs of RAM. It's got MPEG and all kinds of crap that I never heard of. Stuff that you probably never used.
But you'll use it.
Oh yeah.
Well, I don't even know what it is yet. But
we got to go, pal. We're up against a break.
All right. Well
we can finish the rest of the conversation for him. What did you pay?
It was only. It was under $2,000 at my house.
With monitor.
With my.
There you go.
15 inch.
15. Got to get a 17 though.
Yeah, it's only a couple $100 more.
Right. See you later.
What do you mean with monitor? What do I want another monitor for?
I just wanted to know if that price was with monitor. Some of them are priced without monitor.
Monitor's about, what, $300?
Depends. $700 or $800?
No. Yeah.
For a nice 17-inch monitor, yeah. You have a 15-inch monitor. I had a 15-inch monitor, too. 17-inch monitor is like a brand-new world.
Get that NEC multi-sync.
It's beautiful. It's a beautiful thing.
Oh, you guys are sick.
What? What do you have in your home now? You have a Sony XBR.
Right.
You obviously like quality. Well, that's what he just said.
What
quality.
Do I need quality for the computer for? I'm not going to sit there and look at naked pictures all day. I can look at that on the TV.
That's what you just said you were looking at.
What?
What's wrong with looking at naked pictures?
I was
with
just
a nice
checking
monitor?
To see if a thing would come through on here, that's all. And then once it came through, I thought, boy, this is pretty interesting. And it did come right through the screen.
Yeah.
Boy.
Some of it's like you can reach out
took
and touch it.
Took 36 minutes, but.
Right.
No,
well,
it wasn't.
I just wanted to see if
there
if
were a couple
naked
people
pictures
that would
come
want to reach
through
out
what
and
I
touch.
Had. Yeah. Okay.
Hey, I'm the last guy to be defensive about that, Mr. Hotshot.
No,
Mr. Born
I
don't. Again.
Now, what has that got to do
I
with anything?
I don't know. I'm just mentioning that in passing.
Okay.
Since you're trying to get the psychotic.
I'll give you a beeper for Jesus.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Dial-A-Mattress now is our out cue. Remember that. 9:53, 7 in front of 10 o'clock at WIOD.
Oh, that's our new format now. Guess the out cue.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not very good at it. We'll get it maybe like September, November 1st. Fort Lauderdale.
Hi, guys.
Hi,
sir. Checking in.
Who?
590.
Okay.
I called the first time when you and Neil went round and round about this 406 and the legend and how Packard Bell numbers. You guys are so screwed up on computers. It's unbelievable.
Well, at least I admit it.
Straighten us out, pal.
I mean, what, for one thing, the machine that he has got to be a Pentium 60, if it's at all. So that's like slower than molasses. 14,
it is.
14.4 even worse.
Right. That's what it is.
Now you're telling, but a Pentium 60 is still faster than a 486.
Just barely, because you have 486 66s.
Mm-hmm.
So, and that and the sound card, right?
Well, so wait a second. So what is a 486 66?
Wait a minute. Let's get back to the sound card.
No, because this guy knows everything.
No, let's get
in
back
just
to that.
A second. A 486 66 is almost as fast as a Pentium 60?
It has a 66 megacycle clock.
That has nothing to do with it. It's still
absolutely
a Pentium.
It has everything to do with it. What do you mean it has nothing to do with it?
A Pentium has two 32-bit highways as opposed to a 486 that has one.
No.
Yeah, that 66 is only the clock speed.
You think Pentiums all run at 32 bits? You're wrong.
All programs don't run at 32 bits.
That's,
but
you're absolutely correct.
Right, but a 32-bit program does.
Do you think any...
And I have most of my programs are 32 bits.
Well, then you're running Windows 95.
Absolutely.
Let's get back to the sound card. Maybe this guy can tell me something constructive as opposed
all
to you showing us how smart you
cracked
are,
up
which
to
we
me.
Already know the answer.
Well, what I'm saying is, between the fact that you have an old, slow computer...
Right.
It's taking you forever to download
stuff. And it's got a touchy...
You got a crappy sound card.
Yeah.
Plus, you want to say anything about Packard Bell?
I happen to have one Packard Bell and two Acers.
Yeah.
And I have nothing negative to report on either. My Acer's a 166. I just bought it, paid less than $3,000 for it. It's got a 28.8, 16 meg, which connects somehow to Prodigy at 38.4. They must be using some heavy-duty compression there. But you guys are also in the... So trash can the Packard Bell. Go out yourself. Acer has a one-year in-home, three-year total warranty. You can pick them up at Best Buy for a song. I got mine for 28 and change.
Right.
And
that's about what you get a Gateway for.
Yeah, but then I ordered a Gateway, and like I had a problem like you had, where they went back and forth with me about a part that was wrong, and ended up sending it back and saying forget. But they're too far away.
You get a bad experience. Sure, you're not going to stay with the
company. And especially if you're like Neil or like other people, you don't want to be shipping stuff back and forth. You want to be able to go to retail.
You said shipping things, didn't you? Shipping
stuff.
Yeah, you don't want to be
shifting things.
Yeah.
You don't want to have.
Well, you come on here and you say you guys don't know nothing. You've basically said all the information that we have said.
Well, maybe I shouldn't have phrased it that way. Let me just make a suggestion. Trash the one that you've got now. Get yourself a one. Take it out. Put it in the pool. Do the ball peen hammer, whatever you want to do. Between the sound card, the slow modem, and the slow Pentium processor, you're in the dark ages.
Yeah.
So donate it for a tax write-off at its full value.
What should I get?
Guy likes Acer. I've heard good things about Acer.
I never even heard
of Acer.
I have an Acer.
Acer is an IBM product.
That's right.
I have two of them, and I love them. I have a 160. I have the brand new 166, a 28.8. I just got it 2-3 weeks ago. They have 1 year in-home, 3 year total warranty, and you guys are forgetting about some of your advertisers.
Yeah.
iConnect and Web 2000 both have Netscape, so you don't have to worry about that integrated web browser that's built in.
Right, but what I was saying, I went out and bought it. See, I forget. I have Windows 95, and these don't, so I bought the 32-bit Netscape.
Oh, I see.
Well, you know, your programs don't work with each other if they're not compatible.
Well, some Windows 3.1 are not real happy with 95. That's,
right.
That's
They'll
true.
Run them, but they don't really function well.
But as far as iConnect and Web 2000, they offer in 3.1 and 95, so you can set up your Netscape.
Oh, right. When you get it, that's part of the package. They'll give you all the software and the instructions how to do it.
I can fully relate to Neil sitting and waiting and pinging and dropping and cutting out and waiting for your download forever and ever. And you don't have to. And then you do all that, and it says you need an integrated browser. So where does that leave you? Where it leaves you is go out and just get one of the services that have Netscape browser built in, and bada-boom, you're there.
Oh, I know that.
And where it leaves us
that's
is...
That's where I started yesterday at 4 o'clock, was installing that.
Oh, no, I believe me. I've
But that's
and then,
what
and then when I got all through, it said, sorry, unable to,
establish protocol.
Yeah.
Right, well, that's what I
and
told
no matter
him.
What the hell I did, unable to establish protocol, you lose,
man,
sucker.
With TCIP and
you think you got
PPP
a great deal, it was free, but forget it.
You do PP.
So go out to Best Buy, get yourself a nice 166 Acer, get iConnect or one of the, or Web 2000 or one of the people that'll set you up with...
both of them are great.
And we'll set you up with Netscape, and you'll never ever have to get error messages about you'll be downloading to your little heart's desire.
And have a great weekend.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
9:58 at WIOD.
There's a guy that knew what he was talking about, at least. At long last.
He was clueless.
And you're saying I didn't? I said
I never said that. Now you're getting like Phil Henry now. You're getting defensive.
Me?
And he was only joking yesterday.
That's what I heard. Well, I didn't hear it when it was on the air.
Oh, he did say he hates us like poison, but that was he was just kidding when he said that, too.
Jeez, well, I even gave him a number.
Cox made him sign that statement that says that.
Oh.
Everybody knows...
He said he loved Bob Green.
Dunkin' Donuts.
Oh. Uh-oh, get the bucket. Yeah. I knew it.
Everybody
just
knows...
Just the mere mention of the name.
Hi, I'm Bob Green.
Yeah.
Well, they can't see that.
Shake my hand.
Yeah,
my
well,
fingers
sorry,
are all
it disappeared, right. Mm-hmm. Everybody knows Dunkin' Donuts has 52 different kinds of donuts.
I thought it was hot. Only Bob Dole that shook you with your left hand.
Hot, fresh, delicious. Everybody knows Dunkin' Donuts proves it. By the way, did we... Oh, geez, I just remembered. We were supposed to deliver donuts this morning. JC got sick, didn't show up till late. Then they finally got out, and the armored car is stuck someplace without gas and a whole bunch of nice fresh donuts.
I bet you know why he got sick.
Exactly.
Too many colon cleansers.
You
okay.
bet. That's what I was thinking. So anyway...
I bet he's got a scorched rectum.
We'll get those donuts to you sometime. In the meantime, why don't you stop off because... They, oh, geez.
I know a lot of people who'd like to be in on that. Yeah.
What do... you know, I'll tell you what. Let's just remember the name Dunkin' Donut and not really belittle them and talk about them anymore. Maybe you'd like to try some of their nice fresh coffee. It's only 18 minutes old. That's all the older they'll ever let it get. There's over 100 Dunkin' Donuts in Dade, Broward, and Palm Beach. Most of them are open 24 hours a day for your convenience. Have a great weekend.
It's Friday, you bastard.
It's the concert event of the summer. The tour they said would never happen because Jerry Garcia died. And the surviving members of the Grateful Dead said they were breaking up the band. And they did, technically. Sure, they're on tour again this summer, but they're not the Grateful Dead. They're grateful they're not dead because they realized, hey, we were the highest grossing concert act in the world before Jerry up and died on us. Why should we have to give up all that money just because that fat loser did too many drugs and ate ice cream out of a trough? Yes, Jerry's dead, but the others aren't. And they've still got to make a living. Bob Weir, Mickey Hart, and Vince Welnick are grateful they're not dead. The Grateful They're Not Dead tour, because they're making just as much money, and there's one less person to share it with.
Say what?
What?
What's going on here? What the hell just happened?
I didn't do a thing.
So in other words, that's over, because I didn't hear it, in the middle. Was it must have been pretty good. So it was a year ago today that Jerry Garcia died. Yes, I saw what time we got into it, and believe me, I'm very excited about it. I'm thrilled. In fact, if it would have been about 10:30, I'd be even more thrilled. So anyway, thanks for all the expertise on the computer. I really would like to take an axe to it. In fact, maybe OJ will come over with a machete, and the two of us will just tear the stuffings out of that crap, okay? Computers don't have to be so difficult. They really don't. And like I said before, I told Rick during the news, if I just would have stuck with my Quicken and done my checking and my bookkeeping, all that stuff on there, that's all I ever wanted it for. And, you know, the thing in the beginning with the Prodigy and the email, I'm going to tell you really seriously, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart, those of you who are sitting there diddling around with email on your computers, desperately, you must get out of the house. You must go out there, and even if you talk to a robin redbreast, if you talk to a bird, if you talk to an earthworm, if you sit down and have a chat with a bufo toad and tell it to go back where it came from, anything would be a great improvement over the quality of the crap that comes on all these services on the so-called email. The chat rooms, I mean, they should call them rubber rooms. The only thing it does do is give you a tremendous insight as to the desperation and the boredom of the American public. Then you understand why it's so easy to get them all to watch the Olympics. I mean, man, how can there be so many desperate, desperate people out there? I mean, there's only 250 million people in the whole country, which is a lot of people, but very seriously. I mean, it's just all this caca on there. And most of it is on such a juvenile level. Like, remember the email we got on our webpage? We were all excited about we were going to get our webpage for WIOD. And it only took like about a year and a half. And we finally got it. And after we screamed and yelled and hollered about, like, where's all the email that we supposedly got? And finally, Nickel one day put a whole bunch of it in our box. And I looked at it, and you just want to sit down and cry. Because it's all this stuff with all the... You can just imagine like 1,000 Gilberts out there. And the guy with the eyes... and the Italian Iceman, and Greg from Boynton Beach, and they're all sitting around on their little computers, sending back and forth juvenile messages as they sit with their shovel and thing in a sandbox. I'm serious. They got their little pail, their little shovel, and they're diddling with it in their sandbox. So what I thought our webpage was going to be great for was getting those numbers out there and really promoting and, you know, having the audio right on there. Real-time audio. And has that ever happened? Of course not. That would have been tremendous benefit. Then, even during this horrendous summer that we're trying to survive through, then we might actually have some interesting people from all over the world saying, hey, this is pretty amazing. And guess what? And they might have something to say. That would have been really beneficial. And then every time I asked Sarah about the call-in numbers, oh, yeah, I think they are. Yeah, like if you have like a magnifying glass and you understand what the hell they're all about. Have we ever had one call ever from anybody who discovered us on the webpage, the IOD thing? Never. Never. So that tells you we've certainly done it very effectively. And then, of course, those people that came in here that time, remember I had that meeting downstairs? And those people that really want, well, forget about that, because they want to do it right. But, hey, that's okay. I'm glad you're all experts out there. I confess my, I know nothing about it. Well, I wouldn't say that. I mean, quite frankly, I get around on my computer okay until I start trying to do something new and different. Because when you start doing something new and different, it never happens according to the way the instructions tell you. Never, ever, ever. I mean, when you're sitting there for 36 minutes downloading your integrated browser so you can get into right into the World Wide Web from the Prodigy or America Online or CompuServe or any of those services, and the 36 minutes go by, and all right, great. And then you go ahead and you punch in your damn address and you go and say, oh, sorry, if in order to reach this address, you must have an integrated web browser and we offer it for you free. CompuServe offers it for you free and you may download it from the information manager. But I just got through doing that, you jackass. I just sat here for 36 minutes doing that. It's downloaded. There it is. Yeah, but don't tell us that. Tell somebody else. Oh, my God, and you want to take every kind of, like a big mallet, like the one the guy used to finish off that dolphin in the white squirt. You want to take a big mallet and just beat the crap out of that whole computer and just shotcan it. Because it's not worth the effort. So like I said, just sit there with your little, you know, I got that nice laser printer now, and the checks look really professional and really nice, and it's, right, everything is there, the pie charts and the graphs and the this. That's it. Fine. But going through all this other crap, I don't get it. But anyway, happy Friday to you. It's 1013 at WIOD.
Do you wish you could manage your money better?
Oh, God.
Or advance your career faster?
Mm.
Or improve your relationship?
Vagina really gets my panties in a wad.
Okay, 1015 at WIOD. This thing George was just telling me about the fun he's having with his computer. They're really a pain in the ass. I mean, it's nice to have one because, I mean, how can you be an American without a computer? But Jesus, too much grief, too much sorrows. So anyway, what do you think about Jesus coming back on one of those rocks, huh? Wouldn't that be something if they opened up one of those rocks and there was like Moses was in there, screaming and yelling like, let me out. Anyway, let's do Delray Beach on the Purple Line. Hello?
Yeah, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Hey, I want to talk to you. I'm driving in my car. I just stopped for some directions. I want to tell you about something that really makes me mad.
And what is that, sir?
I went into this gas station to try and stop and get some directions. And no one even speaks English in this place in South Florida. You know? Everyone here, I mean, the language is basically Spanish.
Yeah. So we'll learn some Spanish. Take some lessons. Get out of here already. Go grow up. We have two open lines. See, you know what I figure this is? Because I've been through this for 20 years here. And, yeah, I think everybody ought to be able to speak English. But I was thinking this the other day, and I don't know what made me think about it. But the young Hispanics in this town are so far ahead of the game by being able to speak two languages. I mean, the ones that really can speak Spanish fluently, as opposed to some of the ones where it's kind of like fading away and they know, like, maricón, and that's about the extent of their vocabulary. But, or pato, I guess they know that too. Pato pequeño. But other than that, it's a pretty damn good thing. In fact, I'm going to go to night classes and start learning Italian. Because you know that CD-ROM thing I got, that Italian program? You're not going to learn. You can't learn to speak a language from a... I don't care how good the program is. I don't care how much you pay for it, what it's cracked up to be. You're never going to learn to speak a language. You might be able to learn to read some of it and understand it a little bit better. But you're never going to be able to learn to speak a language from a computer. Because it just you just can't do it. And then all they have all these Berlitz programs and cassettes, and I've been through all of that. You can't do it. You have to like go take courses, and you have to speak it, and you have to like do it. But I think it's a tremendous advantage, all these spics down here. I'm not talking about the old ones who refuse to learn English, and they're just adamant and hard-headed and a bunch of hard-asses. Screw them. Here's Pompano Beach. Hello.
Yes, hi. Yeah, I'm calling about the guy that just finished climbing the directions. First of all, he's an idiot.
Yeah.
So don't even worry about him. How about the computer?
I'm not worried about him.
Okay, that's good.
I'm sitting here. I do 15 minutes on my frustration with my computer, and right off the bat, typical South Florida, we get a guy bitching somebody speaking Spanish.
He's
too bad.
Yeah, too bad. About the guy that you spoke about with the computers?
Yes.
As far as that guy with Packard Bells and Acers, if he bothers reading any of the reports, because I'm a tech and I do work on those computers.
Okay.
Packard Bells are good for doorstops. And Packard Bell are good for door stops, and Acers are just a stepping stone after that.
Okay.
Okay, custom computers are the way to go.
Custom computers?
Right, for example, Gateway.
About 15 grand would be good.
Well, no, not really, because he said that the Acer was around, under 3,000?
$2,800, yeah.
About 2,800 for a 166. Well, we can do way more. We can do way better than
that. What do you
mean, we? Well, our company.
Oh.
But,
how did I know that?
Right. Even though it's just pretty much we get a better price because we're local. And instead of sending it back to Gateway in the middle of a potato land, wherever the hell the cows are, it's better to do it local.
Yeah.
So if you guys are interested, we can help you out. But other than that guy should do some read up on his technology with Packard Bell and Acer.
Yeah.
So
in other words, the guy that called before that was talking about Gateway, he knew his crap.
He knew his stuff, right? But he was misleading you. I mean, some people, the thing is that, with Packard Bells and Acer, people have different opinions. Some people have a hell of a time with Packard Bell. They say they love it. Some people say it really sucks.
I don't love it, I'll tell you that, because it seems that, I'm not that computer illiterate. I mean, I'm not a genius, but
right,
I have
that.
A pretty good idea how to get around on it. But it's just everything seems to be such a hassle to do everything on it, you know?
Yeah. And
pain in the ass.
Right, and he said that Windows 95 is good. I mean, it's good, but we run it here in our business, and my God, you should see, we try and fax and go to a word processor, the damn thing just crashes.
That would really be great for me.
Right, that really sucks.
Yeah.
You're trying to be productive by doing multitasking. And,
right.
There goes Windows, out the damn window.
Nice.
isn't that great? You're faxing people, you're trying to say, okay, well, let me get ahead on my presentation, whatever we got
right.
to do, and bam.
And then we go back to in the beginning all over and start from scratch again.
Illegal function.
Uh-huh.
So go figure. Now, I mean, this guy, poor guy. I mean, he knew what he was talking about. He's right about the 14.4 being kind of slow for the internet. But, and of course, those people who spend all their lives on the internet are a bunch of losers.
Oh,
they should
God.
Get out more often.
Desperate.
Those people, date matching on the internet. That's, it's like Geekorama there.
Yeah.
So they're going to have fun. All right, well, take care.
Yeah, if you like guys that look like Gilbert. Okay, thanks a lot, pal.
No problem. Bye-bye.
Okay. Bye. So, okay, there's a good guy. He's trying to sell me something, but that's okay. I have no problem with that. Maybe we'll get a good deal. Maybe we'll get one for free. I doubt that. I sure doubt that. It's one thing to get a few cases of water for free. It's quite another thing yet. And, of course, we couldn't do that anyway, could we? Of course not. Well, at this point. Anyway, it's 10:21 at WIOD. I'll tell you one other thing we get for free that I like a lot. In fact, I sure wish I had a lighter so I could be smoking this Bowser right now. You got one? By chance? Oh, thank the Lord. Leave it to George. One day he's got one, the next day I got one. I thought you were out of here already.
Adam has a lighter.
Oh, Adam's got a lighter. Let me have a little, and he also, he's got his colon cleanser. That's very, what are you taking that to, JC? What are you doing with the colon cleanser?
Rick wanted me to come back and
Rick wanted you to come back and get his colon cleanser. Good, maybe it'll clean his brains out. So I was starting to say, there's nothing like a great cigar from Mike's, okay, which we do get, several boxes of Bowses and Licenciados and Dannemann Lights from Brazil and whatever, because Oscar's a hell of a guy over there. He's the best. He's the best. If you love cigars, they got the best. You don't have to go buy a bunch of illegal crap just because Fidel once spit on it or whatever the hell he did, or something like rhymes with spit. They got all the premium imported cigars that you could ever want, and then some. Maybe even some you don't want. I know they got some that are a little bit too exotic for me, and some that are too big and too gut-wrenching. I don't want to start choking and gagging like Stan Major every day. Anyway, over 1,000 different brands, over 10 million cigars in stock at all time. It's the biggest, it's the best, it's recognized around the world. It's one of the premier cigar emporiums anywhere. And if you want one of their brand new cigar catalogs right off the press from Mike's, just pick up the phone and they'll be more than happy to send you one free of charge. And Dave, call 866-2277. 866-2277. Outside of Dave, call toll-free 1-800-962-4427. 1-800-962-4427. If you love the best, round and firm and fully packed in your puss, head to Mike Cigars, 1030 Kang Concourse in Bay Harbor, open daily until 6, Monday and Thursday, late till 9.
News, talk, and entertainment radio, 610 WIOD.
My God, is that thing real? Tired of those feminine hygiene sprays that smell like flowery cover-ups? Try new FSD Natural Scents, the only feminine hygiene spray that leaves you smelling as natural as nature intended.
There's nothing as romantic as a moonlit walk on the beach.
Yeah, it'd be perfect if it wasn't for that smell.
What smell?
I don't know. It smells like dead fish or something.
Oh, that's me.
Excuse me?
Remember how you said you didn't like those perfumey feminine hygiene sprays I was using?
Yeah.
Well, I switched to new FSD Natural Scents. Now I smell naturally fresh.
But you don't smell fresh.
I don't?
You smell like something that just washed up on shore.
I do?
Yeah, like something that got beached.
Beached?
You know, like a whale or walrus or something. Something that's, you know, rotting.
Oh, that's FSD's new natural scent.
It is?
You think this is bad? You should have smelled me before.
Ooh.
New FSD Natural Scents in original tuna and new cod, carp, and salmon.
1026 at WIOD. We have an open line of date, 751-9463. We have a bunch of CDs here, too, that I was thinking about giving away, but nobody's going to want these. Oh, okay, like I said, we'll do it Monday. Nobody's going to want these anyway. Don't get all panicky. Nobody's going to... There is nothing in here. Even the one, the Beastie Boys, it's like...
Instrumental.
It's an instrumental. Instrumental music composed and performed by the Beastie Boys. Well, who, you know...
I'm so curious. You put that in there.
Who sent us this crap?
What's his name? Mario, Carlos.
Oh, thanks, Carlos, Mario, whatever the hell your name is. Our paisan, whatever his name is, our good close friend. Here's Kendall. Hello.
Is this the Neil Gates computer show?
Yes, sir.
How are you doing?
Great.
Neil,
lonely
guy...
$2 billion.
Yeah, right. The guy that was talking about the custom computers?
Yes.
Damn right. That's the way to go. I used to work for a mail-order computer company.
Yeah.
And...
Which
Packard,
one?
Packard blows.
Yeah.
Acer is just around the corner.
Mm-hmm.
Probably the best thing you could get is a Gateway 2000.
I remember that song, Ace Hole is Just Around the Corner.
It's just around the bend.
Yeah.
And... The way to go is probably get a job done, or better yet, and I'd hate to say this, but most people prefer Apple because it's much easier.
Well, that's what Suds was sitting here mumbling that over and over and over again about Apple. It's simple and it's easy and it's great and it's great quality and you want it. And Rick was good. Oh, no, nothing worse than Apple.
Excellent. And Apple for video, for like people who like to do editing, graphics, and so forth, the king of video. Apple is the best.
Really?
It's easy to use, extremely easy. You don't have to go through configuration.
But isn't Apple... Now, how much does Apple cost, more or less?
Apple is a tad more expensive than your conventional PC computer.
Right.
Like, we're talking about a Quadra, Apple Quadra, or a Performa, which is now a little bit more obsolete, but it's still good.
Yeah.
You know, the only thing you have to do to grab a file is grab it, drag and drop it, and you're in. Instead of just punching up.
Oh, I can drag it and drop it, although I prefer to hang on to it.
I'm pretty sure you can.
Yeah.
Listen, Neil, one last thing. Did you see Christina the other day? She was interviewing, what's this girl from MTV? Luis Miguel's
Daisy Fuentes, yes.
Uh-huh. They were talking left and right about Luis Miguel. I don't know if you saw it.
No, I did not.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, she was spilling the beans on him.
Yeah, I bet she was.
So to speak.
Uh-huh.
Okay,
Neil.
That's
probably all she ever spilled on him, yeah?
Neil, one last thing. Is Neil Rogers God?
Yes. Okay, glad we answered that for him. So anyway, here's the Beastie Boys. They're playing it. They composed it. They're playing it. You don't want to hear it. It's the In Sound from way out. Instrumental music composed and performed by the Beastie Boys. All right. Oh, God. See what I mean? Nobody would take that. You'd have to be, seriously, you'd have to be certifiable. They would put you in Roger Thorpe's cell. And by the way, if you watch The Guiding Light, that was a nice likeness that Roger made, that papier-mâché head that he put there into bed. That sure would have fooled me. And don't worry about Vanessa, okay? She's leaving the show for a year, and then she'll come out of her coma. They'll find some cure. So don't worry about poor Vanessa. She'll be okay. See what I mean about this? You just get the feeling it's not going anywhere. Oh, yeah. And you're right. It's going nowhere.
I see a lot of psychedelic bikes and afros.
Yeah. But it's not going nowhere. It's just, over and over. Here we go. One more time for the West Coast. Come on, here we go. Yeah, there we go. Okay.
Starsky and Hutch.
Oh, Jesus. So that's the Beastie Boys. Okay. Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Good morning, Neil. How are you?
Buenos dias.
Listen, Neil, I have an idea about your downloading problems.
Yeah.
Sometimes when you download a program, you still have to install it. When you download it, what the system does is it saves it in a temporary file. So you have to go back to File Manager, go to your web directory, whatever it is, and look for a temp directory. It's called temp, for temporary. And then you find the program you downloaded, and you have to install it. It's like buying a program. You still have to install it.
Oh, my God. What a pain in the ass.
And that takes about 2 more hours.
Because when I went back to try to load it again, it says this file already exists.
Yeah, because the file exists, but the program is not installed. So the computer cannot.
What a pain in the ass.
Well, you know. It's like buying a program. You still have to install it. You have the disk, but if you keep them in a store, you know, in a drawer.
But why don't they tell you that?
Well, to make it more fun, you know?
Oh, to make it more frustrating. I think the people who invent... I think Bill Gates ought to be shot. I think the people who invented computers definitely ought to be shot because they're sadistic. All they did was just make it as complicated as possible and give you as little information as possible to make it very 10 times as difficult to get anything done.
Yeah, I agree. They don't make it
I can do that, but don't you think they ought to tell you when you're finished downloading, okay, now you have to install this program?
Or at least make a little program with it that will install it automatically.
Right.
You know, that way you don't have to stop what you're doing and go back to the file manager and lose
because
all that
there, there's absolutely, once it's downloaded, there's nothing, done, finished, that's all. And there's nothing to indicate that there's anything else you have to do to use it.
Yeah, but you have to check that out. Not every program you need to do that, but if you're having problems, you know.
Well, at least I still have all those files in there anyway. I've got about three programs that for about 30 minutes each that I downloaded yesterday. And the files are all still in there. They just need to get stuck in the right place.
Yep. That's it. And about the computers, the last one I bought was like 4 or 5 years ago. It's very old now. I'm ready to switch over to something newer.
Okay.
I bought it custom made, like they said.
Yeah.
The best, man. Never a problem.
Really?
Yeah. And you order it as you want it. Okay. Locally, you can see them putting it together. It's great. No complaints.
All right.
Okay, guys.
Okay,
take
pal.
Care.
Thanks a lot.
Bye.
Okay, it's computer talk here for all us computer illiterate folks, and all I can tell you is that it's a real pain in the ass. And even, see, the thing that makes me feel a little bit better is people like Rick who have been doing this stuff for a long time and really fancy themselves as being experts and probably are. But in spite of that, they just have all kinds of hellish problems. They just tear their hair out. They just have a nervous breakdown. So I don't feel so inferior to everybody else just because I'm a novice and because I don't spend all day, every day sitting there wasting 6.5 hours like I did yesterday, tearing my hair out and then going into Prodigy and realizing I could have done it in 30 seconds. That just really frosted my fat, pimply ass when I did that. I thought, Jesus, what is with this? Download this, you clowns. So wasn't I just saying the other day about how much I love Prodigy? I wasn't. Here's Virginia Key. Hello.
Is it you're going into your progeny? What?
Yeah, I'm going into my progeny.
Speaking of going into your progeny, I had to call you today because there was a News of the Weird story about a family of molesting Baptist priests.
Really? A family?
A family. They keep it in the family.
Father O'Toole. God.
Yeah.
Latest dysfunctional family. In May, the Tennessee Supreme Court ordered a new trial for Hickson, Tennessee Baptist preacher Don McCary, who had been sentenced to 72 years in prison for 13 sex offenses against 4 teenage boys.
Nice.
His twin brother, Ron, had been serving time with him at the Pickson prison in Picksville, Tennessee. His twin brother, raping a 6-year-old boy. Their older brother, Richard, a former pastor, is still wanted by authorities.
Their older brother, Dick.
After pleading guilty to molesting 4 boys in the 80s.
Oh! Wow.
So there you go.
The family that molest together.
Yeah, something like that.
Uh-huh.
Plays together.
Like I said, Tennessee.
Well, I think...
Centuries of inbreeding. Trust me when I tell you.
Had too many crossed eyes.
Uh-huh.
And banjo playing. I think the best thing that could happen in the human race next to a large plague would be a gigantic meteorite that's a magnet that would just destroy all the computers on the Earth just so that people would actually have to do something.
Yeah.
You know?
Don't you think that I was doing the right thing when I just used it for my bookkeeping on a Quicken thing and just ignored all the rest of the crap?
Well,
why did I, and I'm not even really sure why I'm doing this stuff now, just out of novelty, just to see if I know what I'm doing on there. And then once you get started, you're hooked, like, can you make this thing work? And the more you get frustrated, the more you sit there and sit there and sit there and says, I'm not going to let this thing beat me. I'm going to get into this thing no matter what the hell it takes.
Right. Well, you know, one of the funny things that you're right about is it's definitely designed as planned obsolescence from the beginning. because you cannot execute it without having some schmuck in your ear telling you what to do.
Yeah.
Now, there's
and then, of course, now, if you're going to call up any of those numbers, you're going to have to wait at least 2.5 hours
exactly.
to get through to anybody, because there's like 50 million people calling in there who haven't got a clue what the hell they're doing.
I could probably get through to get a green card faster than
I
that.
I would think so, yeah.
But, you know, there was a language called Java. There's a language called Java where they actually do import the application, which is the program that runs what you're trying to download.
Right, I saw that.
Right, but they see, everyone's trying to stop that from happening because it cuts the middleman like Bill Gates from selling his wonderful products, etc.
Mm-hmm. Well, screw him.
Yeah, no doubt.
You can
no
just
doubt.
Tell by looking at him what a beady-eyed bastard he is anyway.
No doubt. Bill Gates, you definitely are a king douchebag.
Okay.
Have a good day.
Thanks a lot, pal. Open line of date, 751-9463.
The station that delivers presents
get live with you.
A deliverance weekend. All weekend long, you can qualify by winning video cassettes of the movie Deliverance.
What is it you require?
We require that you listen to the radio all weekend long.
Don't say anything, just move.
The grand prize winner will be flown to Dothan, Georgia for a canoe trip for two down the Cahoodawassee River, including accommodations in beautiful Antrim. It's easy to win.
Now let you just drop them facts. Just take them right on. Them panties. Take them off.
Simply be the 10th caller every time you hear Ned Beatty squeal like a pig. It's a deliverance weekend, all weekend long. From a station that gets you where it hurts.
Q95.
1037 at WIOD. It's not that often you got the chance to witness history, but this weekend you have the chance to do that at Calder Racecourse, or at least you might get a chance tomorrow. Saturday and Sunday, Calder invites you to the Ultimate Racing Weekend. Tomorrow you can catch Cigar in the Pacific Classic as he tries to break Citation's record for consecutive wins. He's going for number 17 tomorrow. I got a feeling he's going to do it, and you're not going to get rich cashing in on that either, by the way. You'll also get a free 1996 edition of Calder's Guide to Two-Year-Old Racing, and there's full-card simulcasting from Saratoga and Monmouth tomorrow, and then again on Sunday there'll be full-card simulcasting, and on Sunday Calder hosts a Grand Slam 3 with the first leg of the Florida Stallion Stakes, plus the first 10,000 fans who show up on Sunday will get a cigar mug absolutely free. So don't miss your chance to witness.
The opinions expressed by the host, guest, or callers on WIOD are not necessarily those of the station or its sponsors. All WIOD programs are copyright 1996 by WIOD Incorporated. No tape recordings or transcripts may be created or distributed without prior written consent of WIOD Incorporated.
Okay, 1042 at WIOD. You know, when I'm sitting here, I'm thinking, what was ever wrong in the first place with having a nice little checkbook? And, you know, you sit there, so it takes a little while to write out the checks, okay? A little elbow grease, and it keeps your right hand in good shape if you're right-handed. Look at what would have done for Bob Dole. He could have probably overcome that war injury with a little exercise there. Write out some checks, Bobby. Come on. Work on it. Work on it. Loosen those fingers up. But no, let's do that. Yeah, that's it. Let's get the Quicken program and start doing everything. And then, even better than that, forget about the checks. Let's just send all of the things out electronically. Let's pay our bills electronically. No way. Thank you. No. There's something. I don't want to do that. I want to have a little more control. I want to send the checks out when I feel like it, and I want to, you know what I'm saying? I want to kite my checks the way I like to do it. Here's a mobile in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
I'm the guy that called earlier on Rick's show.
Yeah.
I kind of got cut off at the break there. The Micron in the gateway.
Yeah.
Listen, let me finish this off, and I can help you out a lot.
Can you imagine how boring this is to all the people out there who don't have computers? But anyway, go ahead.
Yeah, listen.
Screw them.
Barbarians. The guys who were saying that build a computer on your own, that's good, but the only thing is that when something does go wrong, you got to go back to the store and this and that, whatever. If you buy mail order, they send somebody out for the first year on-site in your house to fix it.
Right. I think
now,
we already heard that, yeah.
Right. But the one guy also about the Packard Bell and the Acer, he is full of crap. They're junk. And one thing about the way that they make computers nowadays is everything's obsolete within a year. So if you go out and buy 133, they're going to have something. They got 200s now. They're going to have something a year from now that'll make these 200 obsolete. So what you got to do is buy something upgradable. And the Acers and the Packard Bells are not like that. Also, what you have to look for when you buy a computer is the software packages, because that stuff costs a lot of money if you want to go out and buy your own. So what I recommend for you to do is either A, like I said earlier, is buy mail order. But what you're going to have to do, Neil, is you're going to have to go and look, do some little research in these magazines, because they'll tell you right there in plain English what to get and what not to get. these different companies, they don't use, like, Gateway. They don't use their own products. They go out and put in, a Western Digital hard drive and a Sony CD, things like that.
Yeah.
Not their own products. So whoever uses the best stuff and puts them together is usually comes out to be the best computer. So that's the best way to go. You wait 2 weeks for a computer, you get the best warranties, and a year down the road from now, if you buy a Gateway, which is not a bad product, you buy a Gateway and something in there, you know, your 133, I'd say go with the 133 because it's fairly inexpensive. It's probably about $2,400, $2,500 for everything, you know, sent to you. You buy a Gateway, and a year down the road, everything that you have is obsolete. You can upgrade everything as little as possible. You don't have to redo the whole computer, so it'll cost you $400 or $500, and you got basically a computer that competes with everything else out, and you can keep doing that as time goes on.
Yeah.
So that's the best thing. If you go to a store and try to buy a new one, you're in the same boat as you're in now. You're going to have something that's good for now, but 2 years from now, you're going to want to throw it in the pool again. So that's the whole thing that you got to consider. And also, like I said, the software packages that they send, that they give you with the computers.
Okay.
And that's the loadout.
Thanks.
Thank you.
What do you say? Okay, we have two open lines today. It's 751-9463, 751-WIOD. We have one on the blue line in Broward, 524-9463, 524-WIOD. So what do you think, huh? What do you think? Do you think there's little green men on Mars or what? And by the way, guess what the topic's going to be on Susan Schnook on CNN this afternoon, which they were promoting this morning. The only reason I watch CNN News in the morning is, first of all, because I hate CBS This Morning, which they've destroyed. And number two, because I like seeing Bill, what's his name? Gamal, whatever his name is. Or Bill Hummer. That's what his name is. But anyway, they were promoting the Susan Schnook show. They're going to be discussing, are there religious implications with the discovery of possible life on Mars? So they must have got that from this show yesterday, huh? I mean, that's pretty profound. You know what I'm saying? That's pretty profound. Are there religious... You better bet your sweet ass. You know what I'm saying? As in...
Oh, God!
Right. Here's Bonaventure. Hello.
Yes, good morning.
Yes, sir.
How are you doing, sir?
I don't know. I'm more confused now than when I started.
Yeah, me too.
I've got some people tell me, go buy an Apple. They're the best, and they're simple, and the price is coming down. Then I got the one guy says, you must buy a catalog. You have to get the Gateway. And then I got the other one that says, Packard Bell, throw it in the pool. And then I got the guy with the Acer, and everybody else says the Acer is a deucer, and it's a piece of crap. And I don't know.
You got me there. I'm an illiterate.
Once you get into any of these things, you're dealing with... There are always people that have got an ass to grind. You know what I'm saying? We've got people who sell this one, and they're going to tell you it's the best. And then you got people whose brother-in-law sells something else. And then there's somebody else that's got a lot of Gates stock. So who knows?
Nature of the beast.
Right.
Two quick questions, Neil. One is, I'm sending you a fax on relating to your topic on God. I think think it's very cute.
Okay.
Also, in relation, the other day I was on the road listening off and on the radio to you, in relation to the dish satellites, there was a company, Alpha Star. Was that mentioned at all?
Alpha Star?
Yeah, it's a new one called a 3-foot dish, and the people way out in the islands now can get it. The dish now...
Let me ask you this. Why does anybody want a 3-foot dish?
I don't know. They said they wanted it because it gives a better picture digital.
Right,
like
wrong. Wrong. You couldn't have a better picture than the 18-inch dish unless you reached right in there and grabbed the people out of the screen.
Right.
It's not possible.
And I'm
going to tell you the same thing again. The picture on the RCA or the Sony, the 18-inch dish, there is no discernible difference between that picture and the big 10-foot dish.
Correct.
They're the same.
Correct. He was just wondering because he...
There's a little bit of difference because you're dealing with a digital picture as opposed to an analog picture.
Correct.
There's a little bit of difference in, I guess, the resolution. In other words, the digital picture is smoother. It's almost like pastels,
correct,
but it's a almost indiscernible thing.
This is supposed to be digital also, Neil, and...
But let me say it again. Why do you want a 3-foot when you can have a nice little 18-inch dish that you can hide on a balcony or on the side of the house? Nobody's even going to ever know what's there.
Down in the islands, they have to give an address here in Florida, and they're getting away from that with the Alpha Star.
Yeah.
So that's the reason why.
Okay.
The third thing is, for tomorrow, Pacific Classic.
Yeah.
Can I give you a little tip?
Okay.
Number six, Dramatic Gold, Nakatini.
Upset time, huh?
Don't forget I told you.
Okay.
Talk to you later.
Thanks.
Bye.
Okay, plunge your brains out, folks. There you go. It's no cigar tomorrow. We have an open line at Dade, 751. We got one in Broward, 524-WIOD. 1048. on a really confusing Friday when the largest Toyota dealer on planet Earth's got a sale. They got a big one. Let me tell you, that Mark Jacobson, when he's got one, he's got a big one. I'm not so sure if he's got one, though. Now's your chance to save big during the first major closeout of 1996 cars at Kendall Toyota, and it's also the place with the best trade-in deal anywhere in town. If you got an old clunker, I'm talking about a real piece of dreck, okay? If you can drive it down there, they'll give you at least $3,000 for it toward the purchase of any more than 800 new Toyotas in their vast inventory. They got one price selling, which means the lowest price in the world on your favorite Toyota is right there marked on a windshield in big, big numbers. Even I can read it. So as long as you can drive that trade-in down there, you get yourself $3,000 for it and get yourself the best price anywhere on the new Toyota of your dreams. Kendall Toyota on US 1, just south of Dadeland. Call 1-800-YES-TOYOTA, and they'll give you a quote right over the phone. 1-800-YES-TOYOTA. $3,000 trade offer is on new 1996 Toyotas based on MSRP, excluding Tercels. This offer is not in conjunction with any other offer. One trade per deal on approved credit includes all rebates and incentives. Got that all good.
So let's go to Chicago and have a little chat with Brian. Game 2. Dolphins and Bears. Coverage begins Sunday morning at 9 on the home of the Dolphins. News, talk, and entertainment radio. 610 WIOD.
It's Friday, you bastard.
This summer, discover why everyone loves Pinocchio.
Wait a minute, honey. That ain't a wooden chair. That's a wooden boy.
Quiet, Geppetto. I'm in the middle of something here. Now, Pinocchio, tell me the truth. Did you do your homework?
Sure, but my dog ate it.
Oh, yes!
Sure, he's just a puppet, but with a nose like that, who cares? Don't miss Pinocchio. Coming soon to a theater near you.
I don't know if he likes you, George. Anyway, it's 10:52 at WI. No, I was just saying, Fat Rich is a computer guy. He'd probably come over and get all that stuff straightened out. George says, how come somebody don't want to come over to my house and straighten out my computer because it's all screwed up? He says his windows are so screwed up, he's ready to jump out one. I don't think I want that Windows 95, okay? I'm a little bit leery. I know that Rick is Mr. Hotshot, but everybody else is saying, you don't want that thing. You don't want that thing. And then a guy that said before about how all his stuff crashed, you know, we've had enough crashes lately. You know, for 1 week, for 1 month, for 1 year. Enough with the crashing already.
All these people keep calling up and saying that you should buy a Mac.
Yeah.
Apple Mac.
And the price is almost the same now. It's a little more expensive. Why not? I mean, money is no object. When you're loaded, when you got the big bucks, I'm not some kind of a schlepper here that's asking for like a bargain. I've already got a piece of crap. Why did I start with a piece of crap? That's the question, because I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't have good advice. In addition to which, I thought, well, all I'm ever going to do with this thing is do the quicken stuff, the bookkeeping, and write some checks, and maybe diddle around a little on the email, and then I got bored with that in about 5 minutes because it was caca. It was kiddie crap. See, the problem with the internet, with this whole thing with computers is not kiddie porn. I said this yesterday, and it's true. It's kiddie crap. You got a bunch of overgrown children out there with no lives sitting around, but at least it keeps them off the streets. Exchanging information about how to build a pipe bomb. Good stuff like that. Oh, but you can get it in any library. Yeah, but these people never leave the house. They're not going to the library, see? Here's a mobile in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Hello, Nell.
Yes.
How are ya?
Okay.
All right. I got a good thing for you to do with that Packard Bell.
Yeah.
Use it as a dinghy. Use it as an anchor for your dinghy.
Uh-huh.
It's they're okay. I've got one. But you're right. Technology changes so quick, it's good for holding.
And they don't tell you anything. They don't tell you anything. I mean, I don't get it.
I know. A couple of things. Two nights ago on CBS, I didn't know if you watched it or saw that it was on. Kathy Bates, Sonny.
Oh, but I've seen it 8 million to Misery. Yeah, it's great.
But you gotta come up with a cart. You gotta be quicker. You played that cart every time. Every day for a year you were
playing. But it's not in my DCS, and if you think I know where that card is now, you're dreaming.
You know, I'm on my way to Disney World.
Yeah.
My wife is sitting next to me. That's one of her favorite lines because of you.
Yeah.
You got to scratch it out.
Listen, I know where almost every card, at least the ones that are still here that haven't gotten ripped off or lost, every card in this place is, and the chance of my finding that cock-a-doodie card are like non-existent. I would have no clue. I have no idea where that went.
I have the utmost confidence in it. You've got 3-4 minutes to find it before the break.
Yeah, okay.
Listen, in closing,
yes.
Richie D from the Roni likes a big fist.
Oh! Okay. Okay, now he can see if he can find it. It's gone, isn't it? It's not in here, is it? It would be great if it was by some accident. Yeah. The closest we can come to cock-a-doodie car is...
Cock-a-moon.
That's as close as we can come. Here's Boca. Hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I was listening to yesterday's show there, but I couldn't call in.
Yeah.
And you guys talking about, you know, life on the other planets and all that crap.
Yeah.
You ever see that movie, B-movie back in the 60s, or something like that? It was a planet had all women on it.
No.
And a couple guys crashed their spaceship on it, and the women took them hostages. And then after a while, the women decided, well, you know, these guys here, you know, they started, the planet got all screwed up because there was men on the planet. You ever seen that movie?
No.
Oh. How about George? You seen it?
Have you seen that movie, George? What's the name of it?
I don't know the name. It was just a cheap B movie. It was about a planet with all women on it. They're all lesbos. You haven't seen that movie?
Is it a porno movie?
No, it's a real movie.
Oh,
It was a sci-fi movie.
Yeah?
Never seen it.
Planet of the Grapes?
No, not Planet of the Grapes. Well, listen, if we're talking about life on another planet.
But so what's the point? What is the message?
The point is, when that planet is found, then I'll be interested in life on other planets.
Oh, I see. Okay.
All right. And in
Amazon
closing,
women on the moon, I think.
What, women on the Amazon women on the moon?
That could have been it. I don't know the name of it. I just remember, you know, Planet of All Women on it.
Amazon women on the moon, starring with a cameo by Godzilla.
That could have been it.
Okay.
All right.
Say hi to Faye Ray. Martha Ray. We have an open line on a green line, 1-800-944. Hey, listen, after she did all those teeth spots, that was it. That's when she checked out. She had enough of those denture cream and pollen and spots. She said, okay, I've done my thing for mankind. How's Edie Adams doing, by the way? Is she still come on up and have a good time sometime? Is she still doing that? Now, you're not the guy. It was Phil, and Phil was just putting us on again. We said he never heard of Ernie Kovacs. I do know that he must have been putting us on. I'm praying that it was only a joke. Here's Pompano Beach. Hello.
Yes, hi, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is Rick. I called you about a couple moments ago saying that Packard Bell was nothing good for
you. You know, now, wait a minute. You were already on once?
Yeah.
Get out of here, Rick. No way. We have an open line at Broward. See what this is going to turn into now. I'm so sorry. I am so sorry. I apologize profusely. I'd rather talk about little red ants on Uranus than talk about this. I mean, because now it's going to get into a pissing contest. We got the one guy. They are all experts. And see, this is the problem with experts is that you get 10 different experts, and they're going to give you 10 different. It's like the stock market. It's the same thing. The bears, the bulls, the bull shot, the bear facts, the bear ass. Everybody's got a different story. And when you sift away all the bull crap, you're no farther ahead of the game than when you started. So, and, see, because if they all knew the answers, then the answer would be the same. It's like a question to which they're like, is today Friday? Yes, okay? Is today in this town, in this place, is this Friday? Last time we checked, Viernes, okay? That's it. Although I wish it was Jueves, because I like saying that. But they're all going to give you different answers. So yeah, that's why I'm becoming more confused by the second. But it is going some good time. Here's Fort Lauderdale. Hello. Fort Lauderdale. Oh, we're on hold. Well, too bad. We don't have time to sit around and diddle with your crap, okay? Here's Pompano. Hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Hey.
Oh, that's that clown again. Here's Lady in Hollywood. Hello.
Here's Pompano. Hello.
Lady in Hollywood.
Yes.
A lady in Hollywood on the purple line.
Hello?
Yes.
Hey, Neil. How you doing?
Okay.
Sorry. It's true what you're saying. Everyone's going to call you. You're going to get all kinds of different opinions on this computer thing.
Yeah.
I've got a Packard Bell, and it works great for what I do.
For what you do, yeah.
I mean, because, you know, you're not using it for, you know, building space shells or anything.
Uh-huh.
But anyhow, I'd like to suck around for that Beastie Boys CD.
We have an open line in Dade, 751 WIOD. We have one on the purple line, Mobile One Cell. You see what I mean? If I ever have a woman call this show who ordinarily wouldn't call me if her life depended on it, if we had free breast enlargement certificates to give out, and then start sucking around for something for free, don't do that, okay? There's no lower thing that you can pause. You could go out and, like, put some little kid in a pizza oven for 20 minutes, and I would respect you more than doing something like that. Did you hear that? Shameless. And I was wrong, wasn't I? They're so desperate, somebody would take that piece of crap. Guess
say
what?
Say it like this. 610 WIOD. In Fort Lauderdale. News, talk, and entertainment radio. 610 WIOD.
That because remember all those assholes that were lined up at midnight in Texas and all over America, but especially it was in Dallas or Houston somewhere, and they were lined up like thousands of them because the stores were like staying open, and right at midnight on that night they were going to like open and start selling Windows 95. And I hope that a lot of those people are probably in a loony bin right by now, wouldn't you think? They're SOL, and deservedly so. What were all of those people going to do with their Windows 95? What was
multitask, man.
Yeah, multi-this. Okay, all those techno nerds. That's what we got. It's like, it reminds me of the thing with the laser disc player, and I know Suds takes great umbrage with this, but too bad. It's a piece of crap. And no matter how many times they keep trying to resurrect that, which is, what, about 100 times now RCA's tried to... Because I guess they still got about 3 million of them sitting in a warehouse somewhere. That was the biggest waste of time. The biggest piece of dreck.
And they're always skipping.
And not only do they skip, but you can't Did they finally come out with the one you can record? No, they still haven't done that. And, of course, the promise was, have no fear, because very soon we're going to come out with one you can record on. And you buy those stupid discs, very, very overpriced. Oh, but the quality is so much better than the than videotape. No, it's not. No, it is not. Go on and get yourself a Super VHS VCR. Although, then you got to then start recording a bunch of movies. That's the answer. Because I was going to say, you can't really buy too many Super VHS tapes. And that's a sad thing, too. But, hey, people want to rent a movie for like a buck and a half or 99 cents or $2 or whatever it is. And they're cheap. Which is fine. You don't have to sit there and have like... But we got HDTV coming any day anyway. And it's just got to get better and better and clearer and clearer. Which, by the way, all you computer nerds, I'm really curious. Since there's all this pornography on the Internet, okay? And you go in there and there's pictures of guys doing guys and girls doing girls and guys doing everything that's ever been invented, okay? What is the attraction with that? Do you know what I'm saying? What's the big deal? It's really not very scintillating to watch these, and they're not... Okay, even if you got the best... Thank you so much. The best quality computer that money... The best monitor that money can buy. What is the point? Can't you go down to your neighborhood video store and buy every Debbie Does Detroit and Debbie Does Deerfield and see actually like living it with crystal clear quality, crystal queer? Or can't you go out there and get yourself a satellite dish like the 10-footer and turn on Anik and get like every X-rated channel that's ever been invented? But no, they're watching like still pictures because it's in their computer. It's such a kick to turn on your computer and see a picture of a naked person. Wow! Woohoo! I thought they looked pretty good. Well, I'm not really sure. Here's a mobile in Coral Gables. Hello.
Good morning, Neil. How are you?
Yes, sir. I'm okay. I'm very confused, and I'm very proud of it.
Okay, that's good. Everybody's confused. Listen, about a year ago, I took a basic computer programming class, and I was very fortunate to have a software design instructor teach the class, okay? And I'll give you a synopsis real quick on the different computers, okay?
Please.
Apple is a very user-friendly computer.
That's what I need. Something that's user-friendly.
Well, what I recommend to you, because it took me a year to buy my own personal computer, and I went with an Apple, okay, because I felt it was more comfortable to me than the IBMs or the IBM clones. But there's one drawback to going with a user-friendly computer. You're locked into their own software, meaning there's a lot of guys that bootleg IBM clones computer software. You can borrow back and forth or copy back and forth. But with Apple, if you have an Apple, you have to work with an Apple user in order to get copies of their software.
Uh-huh.
Okay? So good luck to you on your selection. I recommend you sit down and demo a few computers to see which one's more comfortable with you and which one you're happy with and satisfied with.
Okay.
Okay? Have a nice day, Neil.
Thanks a lot. Open line and date, 751. Well, there's a guy who, like, you know, he says maybe the Mac is the answer, maybe not. But he's not selling anything. See, I like that. Because when somebody's peddling something, of course, he's going to have like a little ass to grind. Open line in Dade, 751. We got one in Broward, 524. We got a pair on the Green Lines where they don't know computer from their rectum at 1-800-944-9463. 1-800, do you think all the Yahoos have? Well, they must have if they were all lined up in Texas. Even the Yahoos have computers. The nose pickers. In fact, those are probably the ones that are on all those chat rooms. They're chatting on it. Here's Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Yeah. They're the ones that are exchanging the information about the bombs.
Right, that's a good point.
Listen, I'm God when it comes to computers, and I don't want to get into it. It's just the nature of the beast, and your frustration is evident. But listen, I didn't know God had pimples on his ass.
Yeah.
I sent you a fax concerning computers, and if there's any information...
Maybe that's why he's always in such a bad mood.
Yeah. As many places as I've been into... both public and private, installing computers and whatnot, these techno nerds, you call them, I'm telling you, they make love to the computer. That's their only way to...
That's very sad.
Communicate? It is.
Tragic.
terrible.
Tragic.
I know. And I can't believe not a goddamn word has been said about the big ad in the Sun Sentinel concerning this BS that's going on with the Panthers. They won a 10-year lease.
No, no, I don't. I'm not going to. I don't want to talk about
okay.
it. I'm so tired. And every time there's another rock in the road that we have to hop over, another roadblock. The newspaper and the TV, they build it all up into a big song and dance. It's already the 9th of August. Now, do you think since the season starts? I mean, camp starts in September. I think the first exhibition game is like September 15 or something like that. Okay, so do you really believe that there's any possibility, A, that the Panthers aren't going to play in the arena this year, and B, that the arena deal in Broward's going to fall through when it's already engraved in granite?
I don't think that the Broward thing will fall through, but I never in my life heard of or felt that a small-time politician like Arroyo needed to be assassinated. It's incredible.
What can I tell you? Just keep in mind, he's a pimp. He's just Mickey Urison and the Miami Herald's pimp, and he's just doing their bidding, that's all.
It's sickening. It's as sickening as those people on their goddamn computers. I don't even own one. I build them all goddamn day, but I don't own one because it's a pain.
Okay.
Hey, Neil, it's good to talk to you.
Have a goddarn good day.
You too.
Okay.
That's gall darn.
Gall darn good day. Y'all come back now?
You can't say gall darn anymore.
Yes, I can. I can say gall damn. I can say
GD. You've got no gallbladder.
I can say whatever that goddamn stuff I want as of right now. We have an open line and a green line, 1-800-944-9463. It's 1113 at WIOD.
Hi, everybody. This is Phil Henry. I'm leaving town, as you know, at the end of the month. If you've never heard my show, I want you to know I am leaving town, but please do listen to me in the afternoons. But remember what Mac Davis said, baby, don't get hooked on me. I would want to see that happen to you.
Phil Hendry, 2 to 6 p.m. on News, Talk, and Entertainment Radio, 610 WIOD.
Shannon, I Faulkner.
We all know how Shannon Faulkner's courageous 3-hour, half-a-day attempt to enter the Citadel ended at Hell Week.
It hurts to quit. and I don't think I look good in the shorts either.
But Shannon's story started 2.5 years before Hell Week. And now, A.B. Sleaze presents You Can Go to Hell, I Quit, the Shannon Faulkner story.
Up and at 'em, Shannon. Time to work out. Let's go.
Everyone in the Faulkner household knew Shannon would have to be in tip-top shape to complete the rigorous training at the Citadel.
Dad, I can't eat anymore.
You better eat, cadet. There's 12 more Twinkies where that one came from. Now eat, munch,
learn shoot, how her
go.
Rigorous training changed everything.
Shannon, we're going to have to break up. This Citadel thing's made you too much woman for me.
If you ain't going to finish your fries, can I have
them? You Can Go to Hell, I Quit, the Shannon Faulkner story. It's the movie that proves you don't have to succeed in life. You just have to sell your miserable life story to the networks. Sunday night on ABC's.
1117 at WIOD. We got a pair in Dade, 751-9463, 751-WIOD. Here's Hollywood. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing today?
Great.
I'm calling about your downloads.
Yeah.
About what you downloaded yesterday, was it?
Uh-huh.
Well, what it is before you open those applications, it'd be a really good idea to run it through a virus check. Because I've done it before and actually had my computer system crash from downloading a virus. And it's just not a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And I just thought you'd want to know that, because if you just go home today and open those up, you can crash your whole system.
Really?
Really.
Uh-huh.
As a matter of fact, I have a friend who did it, who was downloading an antivirus program. And he opened it up and it ate his entire system.
Great.
Oh, well.
Great. Another reason just to throw the whole thing in the pool.
Right. Well, I would agree with you if it wasn't my job to sell them.
No, I understand.
So, you know,
I think I was right. If I would have just stuck with my Quicken and stuck with my doing my checks and my bookkeeping and nothing else, there would be no problem.
Neil, you wouldn't have a problem in the world if you would have just stuck with that.
I think I'm going to stick with it.
That's probably a good idea.
I'm going to stick it.
All right, you have a good day, Neil.
Thanks a lot.
Goodbye.
Okay, so how do you like that? Then you got to worry about the antivirus and the hentavirus and the HEPA, whatever the hell it is. I mean, enough already with this crap. Jesus, what, you know, no matter what they come up with, no matter what invention it is, there's always somebody there who can screw it up for you. There's always somebody waiting in the wings who can screw it up. And then we have to start worrying about how we defend against that. So I think, really, you know, there are choices you make in life, and I think the choice you're dealing with here is, what's the trade-off? Is it worth, is what you do with your computer? I mean, if you got a business, I can certainly understand that. But I'm talking about the average schmuck out there like me, or the average schmo out there like George. If you just are using it, you know, to diddle around with a little bit, is it really worth the effort of going through all this crap and all this expenditure of cash and all the heartache and heartbreak and frustration? I think there ought to be a class action lawsuit myself. I mean, Bill Gates has got a lot of money. Let's get together and sue his fat ass or skinny ass. Because I think that they've done a lot of things just to frustrate and aggravate and palpitate and agitate, and they're doing a good job of it. I'll give them that. No wonder he's got all that money. Here's Fort Lauderdale on the Purple Line. Hello.
Don't forget Pulsate.
Yeah, right.
How you doing, Neil?
Okay.
Good. I was just calling to agree with you as far as your computer terminology goes there with the X-rated stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, what's the point in sitting there and watching this X-rated stuff when you can go down to the local adult homo theater?
Yeah, that's right, yeah, and stick it in your nose, right. Or you can go down to your basement and stick it in your ear. Open line today at 751-9463, one on the Purple Line, pound IOD. Here's a mobile in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Okay.
I don't profess to be an expert, and I'm not looking for any free crap, so don't worry about that.
Okay.
Basically,
how about that Beastie Boys?
Right. Basically, I'm just saying, if you're looking for a computer, I've been a Mac user for about 15 years. I love it, but I don't think you're going to be around too much longer. If you're looking for just a regular computer...
Wait a minute. You don't think what's going to be around?
The Mac systems are going to be around for too much longer.
Why not?
They had a lot of problems with the software problems, and people had a situation where... They were going to go in with joint venture with IBM, and they basically screwed them over. There was a big lawsuit about a while back.
Mm-hmm.
And software, I think Mac is still superior. IBM has a lot of problems with Windows 95 systems. I mean, a lot of bugs, and it's basically crap still. But if you wanted just a system for yourself that's good and reliable, you know, it depends what you want to use it for.
Mm-hmm.
If you want it like, for kids and playing on games, Mac has more fun stuff like in terms of games and stuff like that. Business, you got to Windows 95, unfortunately.
Okay, and get a new phone while you're at it. We have an open line at date, 751-9463-751. We got one in Broward, 524. I got to be honest with you, during this hour, well, actually, it started about 9:15. During these 2 hours, I've learned nothing. Because on the one hand, while it sounds like some people are informative and helpful and know what they're talking about, almost immediately somebody else will call and give you the exact opposite. But, hey, that's what it's all about. Right?
You learned something.
What?
Get a Mac.
This guy just got through saying that it's all going to be obsolete in 2 years. Weren't you listening to this rocket scientist we just had on?
That applies to all of it. Everything.
Yeah. So, who needs it? Who needs it then? Have you got money to burn? Are you making that kind of big bucks that you got
yeah,
money
right.
to burn? Oh, there you go.
That's why I'm diddling with a used computer and I can't figure it out and it won't.
Right.
Just
keep diddling
my
with
mouse.
It. Or go down to that cinema with that guy and have a good time. And by the way, he's right. It is far preferable. It's 11:22 at WIOD. Shop. Be interesting to watch. We have an open line on the... maybe you'll be able to download that. Open line on the green line, 1-800-944-9463. Here's a mobile in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Hi, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Okay. First off, I want to preface my call by saying that I have a certain amount of trust in you and respect in you, having listened to you since I was 9 years old, like driving to school in my grandmother's Volvo.
Boy!
Which she wasn't too well for, but regardless.
Yeah.
I'll start off by saying that I'm a computer professional. I own a business in the Fort Lauderdale area. That's not really the issue of why I'm calling, but I do want to set some of these computer people straight in what they're trying to tell you. The basic reason why the Packard Bells, the Acers, the Dells, all the big company computers are basically crap compared to a custom-built system is because in order to cut costs, they're building everything on one component. So basically, they're trying to put everything onto the motherboard, and if you try to do that, you're causing a problem in bandwidth, and it's not a pretty thing. That's the big reason why. It's really a bandwidth issue. They're slower than your average custom-built machine in a real basic sense.
Yeah.
And the other thing is if you use a computer for what you want to use it for, not for what other people tell you you want to use it for. If you want to buy a machine, you buy it for how you need it, and you buy it to the specs you want it, not what Bill Gates is telling you to do, or what this guy from IBM is telling you to do, or this guy is telling you to run this software, or Quicken, or QuickBooks, or whatever. You just have to do it for you. If you don't do it for you, then you're not making a wise decision
in
any sense of the way.
I mean, in all the time, I mean, I've had different aggravations with a computer because I've had two of them in the last 3 or 4 years. But in all the time that I've had one, I've never had so much aggravation as 6.5 hours yesterday and downloading a bunch of crap and trying to do a bunch of crap. And no matter what the hell I did, it just wasn't going to work.
I think they built that pain in the ass factor in there to keep people like me in business.
Yeah.
I really do. But, you know, what do you want out of life? You know, but good luck with your machine. Hopefully you'll get problems worked out and everything should be copacetic.
Okay.
You have a great day, Neil.
Thanks. Bye. Open line today at 751. We got one in Broward, 524, one on a green line, 1-800-944-9463, 1-800-944-WIOD. I mean, it would be like your television set, okay? Your TV set, every time you turned it on, in order to get to channel 6 or to channel 4 or whatever channel you're watching, you would have to go through some kind of gyrations in about an 80-step process to get it. And then even when you thought it was going to come in, all of a sudden, well, guess what? You still can't get it because, well, we're not going to tell you. You figure it out. I think there would be more people doing a Paul Harvey Jr. on their TV screens than you can shake your thing at. Here's Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
How you doing, Neil?
Okay.
Listen, how long have you had your Corvette for?
How long?
Yeah.
Long enough.
Well, how long have you been owned Corvettes?
Nothing. 8 years.
Okay, what did you drive before then?
What did I drive before that?
Before the Corvette.
Crappy cars.
Okay, well, you're buying a computer. Take the same approach you did with the Corvette. You went out and bought a great car, go out and buy a Corvette of computers.
Then what is that?
I don't know. You'll have to find out yourself. An expensive one.
Yeah, but see, there's a big difference, and that is that every day, out of necessity, coming to work, going home, I drive my car. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
A computer, you know, if a computer is that important a part of your life, I guess I would agree with that. But I don't need to use the computer every day.
What, you're just potsking around with it?
Right, exactly, very well put. Just potsking around with it, right.
Okay. Well, listen, I got another call, and...
Okay, and have a great day. Two open line. No, I understand what he's saying, and I said that to Rick this morning. I guess if you're going to start out, you get to the top of the line, you don't diddle around with a bunch of crap. But then you stop and you think I made an investment of. Although the difference really isn't all that much, is it? You know, between $1,500 and $2,400. We're not talking that much of a difference between the bottom of the line and what could be considered the absolutely best that you might buy in your home, right? Am I right? I'm talking myself into it. Here's a mobile in Hialeah. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes.
Quick piece of advice, although you don't need it because you're already stuck with the computer if you feel that way. And to anyone who's trying to get a computer, what you want to do...
Bad phone.
Hold
you're
on,
like
give me a chance. Give me a chance.
You're breaking up. Call me back, okay? I can't give you a chance because it's... like that, okay? I can't give you a chance. Call me back. Call me back when your thing gets straightened out, when they put you in a good cell. 751-9463, 751-WIOD. We have an open line in Dade. Here's West Palm Beach. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
Got the best of both worlds.
Okay.
Here. All right, this is the one you want. You got a Packard Bell now?
Yeah.
So you got a bunch of software on there that you don't want to get rid of, right? You got Quicken on there and a whole bunch of other stuff.
Right.
All right, get an Apple that can do both Windows, DOS, and also the Apple stuff.
Yeah.
And it's only $1,500. The same machine I got right now.
No.
Yes. And you get a monitor. Free monitor. You get a modem. Pretty good hard drive. And
yeah.
You can play, and you can go back and forth. It gives Windows 3.1.
Yeah.
It gives you DOS 6.2. And the newest Mac system.
For $1,500?
$1,500.
With a monitor?
With a monitor. I can even give you the name of the computer, and you can call up the number.
Okay.
It's a Performa 640CD, DOS compatible. You can press a button, it goes back and forth. You can be in Windows 1 second, and you flip over and you can be in a Mac.
Huh.
So that means you can go into a CompUSA, you can go down any aisle, and purchase any type of software you want.
Right. For $1,500?
$1,500.
Unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
You get a modem, you can add anything, you got a CD-ROM in it.
Yeah.
So, and you can, you know, you can play CDs, it doesn't matter if it's an IBM.
It sounds almost too good to be true, you know?
No.
You got one?
Yeah, perfect.
And where did you get it?
Through the, it was through mail order, through Mac Warehouse.
Right.
And I think they're, you know, they probably even have it on sale right now and stuff like that, but I mean, it's a good machine.
Okay, I'll check it out.
It doesn't need to be a workhorse.
Okay, thanks a lot.
All right.
Bye. How do you like that? How do you like that? Like I said, there is a big difference. But, of course, like the other guy said, you know, why spend $1,500 when you can spend $3,000 or $4,000? Here's a mobile in Hialeah. Hello.
There we go. Is that better?
Yeah, that's better.
And anyway, what I was saying is, when you're looking to buy a computer, especially the people that get stuck is the people that know nothing about computers.
Well, that's me.
And, well, and
at least that was in the beginning.
You need this, you need that, you need that. You need to just find out with the applications you want to run, what are the requirements, the system requirements. And then when you find out what, you know, that it's upgradable. Don't buy a system that's, you know, they're getting off the stock because it's an older model and the new technology coming out is not compatible with it. And as long as you have something that's upgradable and, you know, you don't need to spend a lot of money.
Yeah.
And you can start off slow and then say, well, I do need this much more, megabytes of RAM or this or that. And you start upgrading. As long as it's upgradable, you should be okay.
So what about what this guy just got through telling me?
I never heard of that. But then again, I don't buy anything through male or female.
Okay.
And then the last question is, what does Packard Bell have to do with computers?
Where
can I get one? A Packard Bell.
Yeah.
Have a nice day.
Okay. Good point. What does Packard Bell have to do with computers when you come right down to it? We have an open line today at 751, because I'm serious. I really am. I'm going to go home. The first thing I'm going to do is just take that thing and smash it to smithereens, and I'm going to feel a lot better. What?
Well, can I have it?
Oh, can you have it?
I'll buy it.
That's what George wants. He wants me to, that's a good idea. Yeah, you can have it. If I can find that one he's talking about, you can have that, okay? So you better start working real fast and finding that other one.
Right now.
Okay. 11:35 at WIOD.
Calder Racecourse, home of the Festival of the Sun, where there are always more ways to win.
News Talk and Entertainment Radio, 610 WIOD.
Hey, baby, I'm going to use you as a sex toy.
Jerry Garcia, the leader of the Grateful Dead, is not grateful, but he is dead.
His wife had his cremated ashes sprinkled in India and in California, but I wanted some for my fish.
Jerry Garcia was so fat, we had to keep the crematorium cooking for 3 days. There's lots of Jerry for everyone.
I want me some ash.
Introducing Jerry's Human Flesh Flashback Fish Flakes.
Cool. Now my fish can get the same sensation I got at dead shows. F***ing wasted, man.
Driving that train, high on cocaine. Casey Jones, you better watch your speed.
Whoa, he's really blotto.
It's like feeding your goldfish wee brownies, only these are made of Jerry's skin. Hey, I like them too, man.
Look for the tie-dyed kettle at most fish stores and head shops.
11:40 at WIOD, 20 till 12. We have an open line on the green line, 1-800-944. Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello. Mobile in Miami.
Hey.
Yes, sir.
Neil.
Yeah.
I heard you talking yesterday about you signing up to AOL.
Yeah.
Well, let me tell you, they're very eager to sign you up, but when you go cancel, because I was getting these 15 free hour crap on my
That's what
mail.
I got. That's what I stuck in there, yeah.
Yeah, well, I got news for you. You're going to get a bill from now on for $9, whether you use it or not, even though you don't even go past those 10 free hours or 15 free hours. They automatically sign you up. And I was
sign you up for what?
As a membership. You're a member already. Those 15 free hours are up. You don't use your PC anymore. You don't use America Online anymore. And you're going to get a bill for $10 a month.
You mean afterward?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You knew that?
No, I did not know that.
Oh, well, I didn't know that either. And then when I try to cancel, there's only one person in the entire industry that can do that. They wouldn't cancel me. I had to go through hell to get canceled.
Why is that?
Me too.
They wouldn't cancel you right on the phone.
Why not?
You have...
What do? Have to get on a plane and go to Washington or something?
They canceled me on the phone, but they gave me hell.
Gave you hell about what?
About canceling.
Why?
The girl on the phone told me, no, you have to call this 1-800 number to get canceled. And I did, and then she says, no, you have to call this other 1-800 number to get canceled. And they just gave me the biggest run around to get canceled. Finally, I was able to call my credit card, and I
put a
stop payment.
Yeah, this is only America Online?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, good luck, man.
Well, I'm glad they went down the other day. I hope they go down forever. That would be good. Maybe that's just an omen.
I'm telling you.
Okay.
Thanks.
Thanks for the warning. I got news for you. When comes time, in fact, I think I'm just going to say goodbye to them now. I'm going to write a caustic note, and I'm going to mail them a letter and tell them if you don't get that crap out of my computer, if you don't personally come and just get that, take those discs and stick them where the moon don't shine, insert them deep into your
rectum
and get out of my life. Yeah, they must, it must be real, because they had a piece on this morning on CNN about the fact that they're signing people up like crazy, and they're also losing people like crazy. So maybe they make it very, very hard to cancel, but they're evidently people are finding a way, because the piece this morning said that they're, it was on the financial news, about how they're off tourists because people are canceling like it's going out of style. Yeah, exactly, good. Here's Hollywood, hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
You got your tape recorder ready?
My tape recorder?
Yep.
Yeah, I got it. My web core.
Okay. We hate Coroyo. Oh, yes, we do. I think he really stinks. He smells like poo. And now that he got in, we'll get screwed.
Open line in Broward, 524-9463, 524-WIOD. What are you diddling with now?
I'm talking to the Apple guy right now.
And I just want to remind you that the sound card is screwed up on my piece of crap. On my Packard Bell.
That's all right. I got a sound card.
No, I'm just telling you. I'm just warning you in advance. I don't want, even though, of course, the price is right, and I would give it to you for free. See, poor Suds, he just keeps losing out all over the place. First, it was that Laserdisc player that I gave away to somebody else for free, and now it's this Packard Bell that if I buy another one, I'll give to George for free. I'm always giving a bunch of crap away because, hell, it takes up a lot of room in the closet and in the garage and wherever else you're going to stick it. Or maybe just in the dumpster would be good. Here's Wes Kendall. Hello.
Good morning, Neil.
Buenos
dias. Beautiful drizzly Friday morning.
Is it doing it again?
It's doing it. But anyhow, last night I was minding my own business on the way to the library out here in West Kendall.
Yeah.
And I stop off at Dinwixie to get some bread and some soup. And I'm standing in the express lane. And there's this guy behind me. He looks sort of dumpy with a T-shirt on, glasses, curly hair. And I'm packing my stuff in the bag myself.
Yeah.
And this guy starts talking to the cashier. It's Gilbert.
Boy!
And so he follows me out of the store.
Oh, no.
And he starts yelling at me to tell you to change the programming on Waxy. And I said, how the hell is he going to do that?
First of all, how did he know who you were? How did he know you were a listener?
Well, I said, you're Gilbert. I mean, you can't miss his voice.
Bad move, though. Bad move.
Yes, yes. That was my era.
Bad mistake.
But that, he was saying, you get